Hi, wrestling fans. Thanks for clicking the Dreaded D Rose Report. How's everything going? Hope everything's great. I lost my paper here. Hang on. It's getting there. I guess John Cena's been pulled from a lot of the wrestling matches over the week. Well, the shows over the weekend, but he had something up in his nose that the passageway was just kind of blocked on one side. I don't think it was due to swelling either, but so it was kind of a serious nose. Now, whether Rollins is in any kind of trouble or heat on him over that, I don't know. But doubt if he does that again too soon to anybody else. All right, hey, I just wanted to throw this out since all the scandals and stuff is going on too. In 2012 on Raw, remember Abraham Washington, or AW? He made a crass joke referring to NBA player Kobe Bryant's sexual assault case in 2003 and 2013. As client Titus O'Neil tangled with Kofi Kingston in a singles match, AW, or Abraham, he yelled out from ringside, "Titus O'Neil is like Kobe Bryant in a hotel in Colorado hotel room. He's unstoppable." When Raw returned from a commercial break, following the bout, WWE apologized on the air via announcer Michael Cole that and AW, they issued an apology via Twitter, noting that there was no malicious intent behind that joke. Now, again, it was a joke. People can't take, even today, this is a few years ago, today they can't take jokes. But anyway, after all, WWE officially apologized via TMZ, stating that they had taken appropriate actions in the matter. I'm not sure what month that was on, or that had happened. I know it was 2012. But eventually, this led to AEW being released by the company on August 10th, 2012. But if you remember, I liked the bit he did. I thought it was funny. And he was funny, but usually when you get edgy, sometimes you get a little bit go over the edge. Even though I don't think he did, but yeah. Because if he was on late night television, he would have got away with it. Hey, The Rock is at Television Critics Association press tour in Beverly Hills, California on Thursday to promote HBO Ballers series. And he was asked about the Hulk Hogan racist comments, the controversy, what he thought about it, which led to WWE, parting ways with Hogan. And The Rock said, "I'm pretty disappointed with what I heard." He says, "Like all of us, by the way, I've known Terry for, lots of years. My dad helped train him in Florida, and in the 70s, it was when he was breaking into the business. My uncle helped train him, too, as well." He says, "I've known the man not to be a racist." And The Rock added that while there's no justification for what Hogan said, he believes everyone has trash talk, especially in private, he said. He said, "It's funny, it's one of those things where, and not justifying what he said," he says, we've all talked to trash, especially in private, and but, he got it taped and now he's got to pay the price. All right, Wrestling DVD News or Network.com reportedly has got WWE may be making another rounds of those single disc superstar DVDs. Remember this? I think they were real cheap. I think they were under $9. I think Walmart hoarded them out for probably about $5. Anyway, they're going to be similar to the Superstar Collection that was released in 2012. Potentially, it's a single disc for 2015. It's going to be including on separate ones Edge, Steve Austin, John Cena, The Rock, Shawn Michaels, and Undertaker. And it appears that these releases will all be available to North America and Australian fans also. Can't forget the Down Unders. And that reminds me of Lana and Summer Rae match. Anyway. Noted before that U.S. champion John Cena had been pulled from the weekend live events this Monday's Raw and the August tour of Australia due to the broken nose he suffered last week, or this week. Cena has also been pulled from August 10th Raw in Everett, Washington, and all live events that weekend. Anyway, Cena's still being advertised for the final Raw right before SummerSlam on August 17th from Minneapolis. And I don't know if you've ever had a broken nose, but I've been punched in the nose before. I mean, straight on, it didn't break. But I tell you what, it will bleed like crazy. You think it's not going to stop. Then all at once, it's just a big buildup of coagulated. Anyway. And noted before that, way back, that Rey Mysterio has landed a brand ambassador for Paramount Movies in Latin America. Which is why he promoted the recent Terminator movie. And Rey will be incorporating themes from the movie Mission Impossible into his entrance at next Sunday's AAA Triple Mania pay-per-view as he faces the real, or the original, Sin Cara. And also, Jeff Jarrett's Global Force Wrestling promotion held the first TV taping earlier this month at Orleans Hotel in Las Vegas, and Wrestling Observer notes that they had taped five 1 hour TV shows. And there was around 3,000 fans in attendance there, and most of them were comp, though. Don't know what they charged for, maybe only $5 or $10 to get in, probably 10. And one source noted that there were stacks of free tickets for anyone who wanted them at the hotel. All right, recent attendance figure for WWE, and this including NXT. NXT was a sellout of 500 St. Pierce, Florida on July 23rd. This goes on down 23rd, 24th, down to 26th. Anyway, Coral Gables, Miami. NXT had about 500 fans. Bakersfield, California, 5,000 fans. Los Angeles drew about 10,000. And Odessa, Texas, 4,000 fans. West Palm Beach was around 1,000 fans. That was NXT. That was a good draw on the 25th. Lawton, Oklahoma drew about 2,500 fans. And Armadillo, Texas. That's a hard word to say. Armadillo. Drew about 3,500 fans. That don't seem like very many unless that was a small venue. All right, WWE is looking at doing live specials on the WWE Network. That's going to be I guess they're going to be taping it on a beach. Didn't say what beach yet. Similar to the first, remember WCW did that bash at the beach about 20 years ago now. I don't know whether they're going to the same place or someplace else. I'm not sure whether they're trying to get some more people over to the network too. They're good. Network, I guess, is really working out pretty good for them right now. WWE officials, since they got over, I think they're 1.1 million or 2 million, people. WWE officials now have the idea of they want a Latin female star of the company. They're looking for sexual appeal and Spanish speaking skills for someone who can be front and center helping to expand the WWE Latin audience. If you happen to be a Latino, the male, get yourself some surgery, and that they'd like to promote that themselves, and become a Latin female star. Bah. Anyway, there's our reports going around stating that John Cena underwent emergency surgery on Monday night and early Tuesday after the broken nose deal with Rollins on Raw. Cena had pulled him from the weekend live events, which I already told you about. And it's expected that Cena will face Rollins at August 23rd SummerSlam, but that hasn't been announced yet for a fact. They were kind of building up to it. But this is going to leave this kind of a short one, so you don't have to put up with my voice very much longer. But got any questions? Hey, leave them in the comments, and I'll get around to answering them. I thank you. I gotta go.